Okay, so in this tutorial we will see that how we can record the lecture. So first of all, in your browser go to teams.microsoft.com. So once it gets opened, go to the Teams tag over here and create or join a team. So I'm going to create a team over here. Just give it a name. I suppose there will be four options when you are creating the team. So go into the class option and just give it the name lecture recording, and it is just a tutorial. You can give the description of your this team. Just press next, and then it will ask you to add any member to the team if you want to add as a student or as a teacher. So I'm going to add myself in this one. So let's suppose is this, then I have added this one. So now this team is ready. Okay, so it will open this window in front of you. So there are a number of options over here: activity, chat, teams, this, and you can explore all of these at your end. I am just moving forward directly to the recording of the lecture. So over here you can see there are options. Just click on Meet Now. So once you click on this one, and it will ask you to share your video, so you can keep it on or you can turn it off. Okay, so now let's click on Meet Now. So it will bring this window in front of you. Over here you can share your screen or you can start recording. So just click over it and start from here. You can start recording your lecture. Okay, so before starting the recording, I am just going to share, and I am going to share whatever is there on my screen. So desktop is over here. You can select your desktop that will be shared, or you can select an application window that will be visible during the lecture. So first of all, I am going to select the entire screen over here, and I am going to click on the share. So it will start sharing the whole of your screen, and once you share your screen, then click on start recording, and it will start recording your lecture in the cloud. Okay, so once it is done, now you can open any window, and you can deliver your lecture from your PDF or from the Word file or from the PowerPoint. Just you will be speaking, everything on your screen is being recorded automatically by the Microsoft team. Any application can be opened. As I'm opening different applications, I have written some notes for my students, so you can explain the things over here with the help of the mouse or the cursor. And once you are done with that, go back to your screen of the browser, and it is basically recording everything what has happened on your desktop. During this, make sure that your internet is intact and it is on, and because this lecture is being recorded in the cloud. So once you record that one, you can stop sharing your screen, and you can if you want that only one particular screen is shared with the audience, so you can select that particular screen. Let's suppose I can click again over here. You can, if you say that only PDF screen is visible, so just click on the PDF, and this screen is basically being shared with the Microsoft team member. So you can explain the things, and then you can go back to your Microsoft team in the browser, and over here just once you finish the lecture, stop recording. But I will just suggest you to keep sharing your desktop. Everything over the desktop will be recorded as a part. So once you are done, click on the stop recording, and once you do this activity, then you can finish the meeting by clicking over here. So now come back to your this Microsoft Teams screen. So you can see over here, recording has stopped, saving recording to the Microsoft Team. So it is doing everything in the cloud. Once this meeting is saved, then you can just over here you will be seeing number of options that you can share this video, you can see that video on Microsoft stream. So once that is done, there will be number of options. So it will take time, it will take 5 to 10 minutes for the for the saving of this video. It depends upon your internet speed. I think it has already taken the things in the cloud, now it is compiling that one. So normally I have observed it takes 5 to 10 minutes for the saving of the video, and it also sends you an email and that video has been saved in the MS stream, and from there you can see the video or you can share the video. So it will take certain time, just wait. Okay, so once it saves the video, then we will move onward. Okay, now you can see it has saved the meeting in the cloud, and now there are number of options over here. You can see the share, open in Microsoft stream, get link for this one, and from here if you get the link, you can share it with the students. Okay, and you can share it in your organization, and you can open it in the Microsoft stream. So let's see what it has done. So it is opening in the Microsoft stream, and let's play it over here to see that what it has done. So let's start this one. Okay, so now this lecture is recorded, and now you can share it with anyone by clicking over here. It will remain there whenever you want to share. You can share it, and even if you want to download it, you can go to the Microsoft streams, and over here you have number of options to modify this lecture, to even you can even edit this video. So if I go over here and if I see how many videos I have uploaded, so it will show the many ones. So this one over here, if I click over here, you can see over here the download video. You can download it and save it to your computer. If you want to edit it, you can go, if you want to cut something from your video, trim video option is going to be there. If you want to delete it, this option is also there. So you can do a number of things with your video, and you can now I think record the lecture for the students. So thank you very much. I think this tutorial will help you to record lecture and share your material with the student in a very easy way, without caring about anything. Just you will have to care about your internet connection. If you have a good internet connection, then it is not a problem. So thank you very much.